Hi, we'll be going through the CAT exam questions which we had just attempted. So this building basically is an electrical building which houses all the instruments for and substation, what is typically known as a substation. And it's a G+1 building, and we'll go through the questions and also try to understand something more about this building which we just solved for. So the first question is asking about the number of windows of type W. So if you see the number of windows, it's just a straightforward maths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 in the ground floor. There are 14 in the first floor. There's an additional window here, which is not shown in the plan here. This is because of the toilet which is there in the ground floor. It's not there in the first floor. Hence, we are having the 14 windows in the first floor. So 13 plus 14 make 27. So thickness of the brick wall is 250 mm in this case, and 125 mm for the internal partition walls of the toilet area. And the third question, DPC, of course, this is a damp proof course. It's provided so that moisture doesn't move from the basement to the wall above. Moisture movement causes unsightly stains and also sometimes algae growth and things which will appear which will ruin the appearance of the wall. Here we come for the next question. At what height is TOC of slab over first floor? So for that, if you have a look at it, slab of first floor is, this is the first floor, so slab of first floor is here. This will work out to 10.2 meters, and from FFL to FGL there is a 0.5 meters, so totally it works to 10.7. and what is the difference between internal and external plastering? One is the thickness, the other is the number of layers in which it is made. Apart from that, as the specification is the same, one is to 6 cement mortar. However, it is in two layers. The external plastering is in two layers. This means that the labor is twice, and definitely the quantity has to be taken separately for external and internal plastering. Over and above this, we also have the external plaster requiring additional projections of columns which have to be accounted for. Hence, external plastering has to be measured separately. Now we have the part B questions. Evaluate the length of the drain around the building. So here it's a very simple thing. If suppose you have a look at it, we are having a grid, the grid drain here. This can be moved over here. Essentially, if you move this bit here and this bit to the periphery, we will, and same thing being done below, it will become one big rectangle. And this length is actually over and above the grid. You'll have to take 750 plus 100 plus 250, which approximately 150, which works to 1 meter. I am deliberately leaving out the thickness of the wall, and hence it means that you will have to add 1 meter beyond the grid to get to the center line. So 4 plus 1 5 11 17 and 17 plus 4 21 22. In the same way, if you have a look at it on the other side, we will have 30 meters. So 22 meters here, 16 plus 4 20 plus 2 22, and in the same way 38 meters, totally 120 meters. So the quantity is actually measured, it's a straightforward measure. If you have a look at it, you have 2.97 meters here, and above that we have a 1.25 meters and two partition walls. Basically, I would prefer to add up this value to get this partition wall. Here there's a 1.6 meters minus D1 width, which is 1.2 meters. So here you'll have 0.4 meters, 1.2 meters, yes. So here it is 1.6 and 1.2. Of course, it's not drawn to scale, so these doors and all this, so that is why you are having the look, I mean, it looks bigger. And so that value will work out to 16.5 meters square typically. And of course there are windows and ventilators which have to be deduction has to be made for, and two main doors. So if you have a look at it, it will work to 8.57 meter cube only the deductions. It's straightforward. Multiply the volume for windows, for brickwork and ventilators and main door for the brickwork. This is again a very straightforward thing, says it all. This is 0.64 meter cube. So how would I have worked it out? If you have a look at it, you can either do it as three rectangles, or you can move this rectangle over here to make it one big square. So either way it still gives the same value, or you can take the mean value, take this, multiply it by 3. Whatever is done should come to 0.64 meter cube. And 10.2 is the total height. 10.2 is the height from ground floor to the terrace floor level. So 10.2, if I'm dividing by 84 equal rises, it comes to 0.120 meters. So of course here we are only having the excavation per pit. We have 14 pits, you will get it. And when I say grids, the grids are only the external grids. Over here I think it was asked as grid 1 and grid 3. So grid 1 and grid 3. So only these columns are required, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 into 2, 14. Backfill and transport is from usual definition. Trust you found it interesting. Bye for now.